In the realm of Earth's formidable natural phenomena, volcanoes stand out as one of the most unforgiving forces. Picture this. Should one plunge into the fiery embrace of a volcano's magma-filled center, their body would swiftly bubble up, leaving no trace behind. Now, an intriguing notion arises. Considering their remarkable ability to obliterate, has anyone pondered the idea of using volcanoes as the ultimate disposal solution for our earthly waste? Imagine, for a moment, if we could transport our vast amounts of trash into these fiery abysses. It sounds tempting, doesn't it? Yet, delving into this concept unveils a myriad of challenges. Americans alone generate a staggering 254 million tons of trash annually. While the idea of dumping it into volcanoes might seem like an ingenious fix, the reality is far from simple. Volcanoes, despite their appearance as nature's garbage incinerators, prove to be both perilous and unstable. Additionally, accessing them presents a daunting task, raising the question, is overcoming these obstacles truly worth the endeavor? Embarking on this volcanic garbage disposal quest brings us face to face with the first formidable hurdle, locating a suitable active volcano. With only around 1,500 potentially active volcanoes worldwide, and most situated in remote, uninhabited areas, transporting our trash becomes a logistical and financial challenge. The journey to an active volcano is not only potentially exorbitant, but could also lead to the realization that it might not even be the right kind of active volcano for such a disposal mission. In our pursuit of the ideal volcano for trash disposal, the Shield Volcano emerges as the sought-after candidate. Known for its gradual eruptions and iconic lava lakes, these volcanoes are, unfortunately, a rare find. Instead, one is more likely to encounter their tempestuous relatives, the stratovolcanoes. These volcanic giants are notorious for explosive eruptions fueled by the buildup of pressure from hot gas and magma. In essence, not the safest locale for a town dump. Now, let's entertain the notion that we're fortunate enough to stumble upon an active Shield volcano. Before delving into the logistical challenges of transporting our trash, envision yourself as one of the pioneers tasked with driving up to the vent of this majestic volcano. It's at this point that the harsh reality of career choices might dawn upon you. The vent of a volcano presents a treacherous environment ripe with poisonous gases, lava splatter, and projectile rot. As a waste collector, navigating this perilous terrain prompts serious contemplation about the chosen profession. In 2002, Ethiopian researchers embarked on a daring experiment by tossing a 30-kilogram bag of trash into a volcano, and the outcome was explosive. The inherent instability of lava lakes proved crucial, piercing their surfaces with something as seemingly innocuous as trash triggered a cascade of explosions involving pressurized and acidic steam. Now, envision the scale of these explosions if an entire nation's worth of trash were to meet this fiery fate. To provide context, in Hawaii, rockfalls into lava lakes have propelled lava an astounding 85 meters into the air, painting a vivid picture of the potential magnitude. Yet, even if the logistical puzzle of safely delivering our trash into the volcano were miraculously solved, a new set of concerns would emerge. The act of burning our waste within the volcano would unleash air pollution, absent the protective embrace of filters. This added environmental impact compounds the ethical dilemma of using volcanoes as our trash incinerators. Furthermore, not all materials would gracefully disintegrate in the fiery depths. The persistence of non-degradable remnants in lava could lead to the unsettling scenario of pollutants erupting out and contaminating the surrounding landscape. Or, if you're thinking of burning nuclear waste in volcanoes, consider the additional environmental impacts that would accompany such a venture. Layering these repercussions on the logistical challenge of shipping all our trash to these fiery pits raises a red flag. Not only would it significantly inflate the carbon footprint of waste disposal, but the entire concept starts to resemble a misguided endeavor. If our intention is to incinerate trash, why not choose a location where the heat released through this process can be harnessed to create new sources of energy? or shooting our garbage into space may seem like an appealing escape route. However, delving into the potential harmful effects in the cosmic void becomes a discussion for another video. And yes, if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to see more videos like this.